Hey guys, it's Chris. From planets that are freezing on one side and cold on the other, to planets covered in diamonds, there's a lot we still don't understand. Here are eight of the strangest and most mysterious planets we've discovered so far. Number 8. Planet 9. Once upon a time, the solar system that contained Earth had 9 planets, the 9th of which was called Pluto. Hey, you remember those days? However, eventually that title was taken away from Pluto. Poor Pluto. So now the solar system only has 8 planets. Or does it? Scientists have been looking at the outer reaches of the solar system and have noticed some strange anomalies, mainly in the orbits and paths of certain objects that don't line up with how objects should orbit the sun. Their theory is that somewhere out there in the outer realm of the solar system is a hidden planet. Planet 9. I'm sure on some level this may seem very strange, as you would think that we would know if there was another planet out there, especially if it's as big as they think it is, in order to affect the orbits of the objects mentioned. However, despite many man-made objects looking into space, we can't possibly cover the entire solar system with a gaze, as the system is many millions of miles wide and long. This adds to both the strangeness and the mystery of Planet 9. Because since we can't see it, we don't know where it is right now, how big it is, what it's made of, and more. Yet the science and theories that say it's there, well, they're sound. Should it be found, it would be a great historical discovery. But until that point, it's still only a theory. Number 7. 55 Cancri E. Planets are very much defined by what they're composed of. And for 55 Cancri E, well, that's diamond. Yes, this is a literal planet that is made of literal diamonds. So how did this come to be? The planet itself was actually a star in the beginning of its life. It was part of a binary system, which meant that there were 2 stars in the area. Over the course of some time, the partner star tried to consume it. But since the star had carbon inside of it, the process couldn't be done completely. The enormous strain and pressure of the partner star instead turned 55 Cancri E into one made of diamonds, mostly. It's about 1/3 pure diamond, with other materials making up the rest. That being said, even 1/3 diamond is very impressive for a planet of this size. 55 Cancri E is twice the size and 8 times the mass of Earth. So when you do the math on the planet's size and the value of the diamond at current pricing, you get $26.9 million worth of diamonds. 30 zeros in that number, making this one of the most valuable planets out there. Or at least in regards to the diamond sections anyways. And now for number 6. But first, let me know your favorite planet in the comments below, and be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. Number 6. GJ504b. Planets are known to be many different colors, but can you think of one that is a solid shade of pink? If you were to head 57.3 light years away from Earth, you would find a planet called GJ504b, and it's in fact a planet that is 100% pink. Or to be more colorfully accurate, it's a shade of magenta. So the obvious question is, how does a planet get wrapped in a shade of pink or magenta? And that would be because, while it's a fully formed planet, the process that made it a planet hasn't burned through yet, meaning the heat that helped make the planet is still around on GJ504b. As a result, the planet is pink. Oh, and it should be noted for the record that this planet is the size of Jupiter, so it's not just a pink planet, it's a very large pink planet. But that's not all that's interesting about GJ504b. As scientists noted its place within its particular system, they noticed that the planet is actually incredibly far from its own sun. And yet, it's a massive planet. So that seems to contradict what the scientists of Earth feel is necessary to create certain kinds of planets. Because since it's so far from the sun, the debris needed to make it shouldn't have been around to form the planet. Yet there it is. So it's big, it's pink, and it's a mystery to the people of our world. Once again showing the universe has mysteries that we just haven't cracked yet. Number 5. HAT-P7b. On Earth, weather patterns help determine how people interact with the day at hand. But one thing that they never have to worry about is it raining precious gems. Unlike HAT-P7b, where that just happens all the time. This is a planet that quite literally rains rubies and sapphires. Those are 2 of the most precious gems on Earth. So how exactly does that happen? Well, Dr. David Armstrong wrote a letter on this phenomenon, stating, "Condensation models of HAT-P7b predict precipitation of corundum on the night side of the planet's atmosphere. Because corundum gems are rubies and sapphires, one can describe the hypothetical weather on the planet's night side as raining rubies and sapphires. The mystery and oddness of this is only added upon when you learn that HAT-P7b has many storms going through it. So by that very token, that would mean that the surface of the planet is covered in rubies and sapphires that have rained down from above. As for what the surface of the planet is, well, we don't know. And it's not for lack of trying, but rather HAT-P7b is also one of the darkest planets in the universe. It absorbs 97% of all light sent to it by its sun. So even with our most powerful telescopes and probes and satellites, well, we can't see the surface. Number 4. WASP-12b. I want you to take a second and think about the shape of our planet. And if you were to call it a shape, you would no doubt say it's a sphere, right? No true elongation within it, right? However, the same cannot be said for the planet known as WASP-12b. For this is a planet that is well and truly elongated. And it has to do with the sun that it's revolving around. The planet is egg-shaped due to the massive amount of gravity that the sun it encircles exudes. And this is only one part of the strangeness of this planet, because the gravity isn't just elongating the planet, it's killing it. Worse, it's killing the planet slowly. So in about 10 million years or so, the planet won't be around anymore because the gravity will have caused it to die. Finally, the planet has one of the lowest densities of any exoplanet out there, adding one more layer to its very unique state of being. Number 3. HD-189733b. HD-189733b is one of the strangest planets in existence and features a feat that no one likely thought possible, or really even desired. You see, this is a planet that rains glass sideways. No, this isn't a trick, or something seen in a sci-fi movie or TV show, though some have featured similar things to this. It's a real planet, and it really does this. I'm gonna take a second and explain how. The glass itself comes from the atmosphere, which has a high concentrate of silica, a component very common here on Earth. Because of the buildup of silica, as the rains come down on the planet, it hardens, not unlike condensation from water to ice at times on Earth, and thus it becomes glass. So well and truly, glass can truly rain down from the skies above. The winds on HD-189733b are far beyond anything Earth or many other planets in the universe could do. They're so powerful, they can be up to 5,400 miles per hour. The force of this wind at such high speeds makes it so the glass rain can't fall straight down, and instead it falls sideways. So what you get in return is a planet that is beyond logic, and yet is fully explained by science. Number 2. KELT-9b. KELT-9b is a planet that is well and truly burning the life out of itself, and is in fact the hottest exoplanet ever discovered in our universe. Thankfully, the planet is about 950 light years away from Earth, so humanity won't have to really worry about it. But the planet itself is dying in many ways. One of which is that it's tidally locked with the sun in its system. And that means half the planet is always facing the star, making the surface of the planet hot on one side but freezing on the other. The kicker in this situation, though, is that the planet is 3 times the size of Jupiter, and it burns with an intensity of 7,800 degrees Fahrenheit, which is close to what the Earth's core burns at, or what our own star burns at. Because of this heat and its own star's influence, the planet will die as it's burning up the gases that comprise it. Granted, it is going to take a few million years to get to that part, but it is going to get there, and nothing can stop it. Number 1. Earth. Objectively, Earth is one of the most strange and mysterious planets in the universe, and for reasons you no doubt have heard before, including the fact that as of right now, we're the only planet in the universe with life upon it of any nature, well, that we can see so far anyways. But let's look at this from another angle as well. Mainly, one of all the Earth-like planets that exist in the universe. There are many, and many are potential places for us to live upon. And yet, there's not a single planet that we have found in this universe that is perfectly like Earth. or even close to it in many regards. There are many Earth-like planets that are the same size as Earth or even have a sun that is like our own. But either the atmosphere doesn't have the same effects, the planet is gaseous and thus has no land masses, is covered in water, or has many other factors that make it a close but no cigar situation. If the universe is truly random, why is it that there's only one Earth-like planet that we can see amongst the stars? Surely that random nature means that there's a couple, maybe one or two, maybe even a dozen planets it's like Earth out there, but no one knows the answer. And that's why the mystery is so compelling. Thanks for watching. What did you think about these strange and mysterious planets? Which one was the most strange or most mysterious to you? Do you know of any other planets that could have been on the list? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe to World List, and I'll see you next time on the channel.